Hi you guys, this is Chef Nett coming to you with Cooking and Entertaining with Chef Nett. And today we are going to be making a orange Cajun beer chicken. Yeah, good, right? Well, for those of you who don't drink alcohol, don't worry. This is not gonna make your chicken taste like alcohol. All it's gonna do is give it an extra boost of flavor and love. Okay, that's it. If it's that big of an issue for you, don't worry about the beer. Skip that step altogether. But for those of you who aren't afraid, for those of you who want to try something new, something different, but yet delicious and easy as I don't know what, don't skip this recipe. Now, I won't be giving you the full recipe in this video. You will have to go to my YouTube page to check out that, okay? But we're gonna start with this butter, and I do mean butter, not margarine, but if that's all you have, that'll work too. But I'm using unsalted butter. Reason being, we're gonna season this butter so it doesn't need to start off with already having salt in it. So, first things first, let me grab a spoon. Okay. First ingredient we're going to pop in this baby is real easy orange marmalade. Okay, remember we did say that this was going to be a Cajun orange beer chicken, or orange Cajun beer chicken, or Cajun orange beer chicken, whichever you like. Same thing. Okay. Then we're going to go with 1 teaspoon of smoked paprika. We're going to use another teaspoon of blackening season. And actually, believe it or not, this is going to add another boost of flavor. Dill, secret ingredient to a lot of my dishes. People always wonder, what's that flavor? Can't figure it out. It's probably dill. Then we want to go with some dry rub sage. I don't work my spoon in here. Doesn't want to come out. There we go. And we have some oregano. Wasn't that much in there, about a teaspoon left. Creole seasoning. Teaspoon of that. Now we have Montreal steak seasoning, and we're going to put a full tablespoon of that baby in there. Teaspoon of granulated onion powder, teaspoon of garlic powder, and then we have a tablespoon of parsley. You're just gonna mix this baby up. Now, we're gonna be using this rub, this butter rub, on our chicken. So you wanna make sure that you have all of those wonderful flavors completely incorporated there. All of the butter is nice and happy, well seasoned. Now we're gonna move that to the side and get ready for our chicken. Okay, y'all, I got my chicken ready. And now all I'm doing is slathering on that butter nice and generously. We want this baby to be happy everywhere.